Hey y'all, what's going on? Popping in here to do another episode of That Gay Shit. So this is the scenario. I'm going to run through it real quick. So I've just broken up with my girlfriend of 2.5 years because I found out she cheated on me twice with a male. She denied everything at first, then admitted to only doing it once, then finally admitted it happened twice. She told me she wanted it both times. Her reason was because she wanted to see if she missed the real thing. Now that I've broken up with her, she's constantly messaging me and begging me to give her another chance. I told her it won't work because she's confused and doesn't know if she's a lesbian or not. She claims she is. Now I'm stuck between a rock and a hard place because I've grown so attached to her son, who was about 9 months when we met, and he's now 3. We're currently in a long distance relationship till I found out. Do you think the saying is true? Once a cheater, always a cheater? All right, let's break this down bit by bit. So you found out she cheated on you not once, but twice. Now, my thing is this. Look. Oh, and then she wants you back. One time, I don't condone cheating at all. Okay, so it happened one time. The second time, look, what they say, shame on you, then shame on me. We ain't reaching the third time. If she did it one time because she said she was missing the real thing, and if you don't know what that means for, you know, those new non-gay viewers, that's talking about the dick. Because in some lesbian situations, we use strap-ons. That is let's call it the mimic of a penis. Okay, some of y'all may be confused, like, but if you, why don't you just be a dude? Look, you could take the shirt off and put it in the drawer, you still have a woman. It's not hard to understand. Lesbians, it's women loving women. Some women like penetration. Hey, you could put it on, take it off. Different flavor for every day of the week. How you doing? Let's move right along. Now, so she cheated on you twice to see if she missed it. One time, how much does it take for you to realize if you missing the bait? Look, this is my opinion. I'm putting myself in the situation like I always do. No, you ain't getting no another chance. Even if it was one time, hell to the nah. I'm sorry. Because, I guess this is why I'm so big on communication. If I was in the situation, I'd want my partner to talk to me about it, because this is some problem that some lesbians have, you know, with a woman that likes, you know, the strap and stuff. They think, oh, does she want the real thing? Does she like the real thing? Oh my God, will she leave me for the real thing? This is a conversation that you should have with your partners if you're in this situation. And so me, one time, two times, no, I don't want you back. I don't want you back. It's a song like that, right? Yeah, moving right along. Yeah, you say you're between. And yeah, I question that too. You not no lesbian. I'm sorry. Because my whole thing is, if we together, y'all was together for 2.5 years and you giving her the D and she wanna know she missing, so she go get the real thing once. Twice. What didn't you get the first time? Yeah, moving right along. You say you're between a rock and a hard place because of the child. Now, okay, this I can understand. It can be difficult. I can understand the attachments that, you know, those who are in relationship with a partner that has a child. I get it. But I'm sorry. I am not going to be with somebody because of the kids. And, you know, it's different if it's like your biological child. It's different. And some may say, like, oh, how could you say that? Listen, my partner has kids. And if, you know, something happened, that attachment's gonna be there, but I think that I can still be in the kid's life. You know, depending on the circumstance, because, yeah, you got, you know, because that's something you gotta work out with, you know, that's a discussion that should be had as well. If you with somebody that has kids and it's in a, you know, it's been, you've been together 2 years, that's a discussion should have came up. You know, God forbid something happens. Or am I gonna be able to be in the child's life? Am I gonna be able to have this relationship? So I think that's a discussion you can have with her. I mean, you say she's calling you and messaging you. That's the conversation you should be having, not can I have another chance. No, you want dick, go have dick. Now, can I be in the kid's life? That's the discussion that I would be having. So, I don't know. Hopefully I answered your question. So first of all, look, do I believe he wants to cheat or is a cheater? I don't know if I would say wants to cheat or cheat, but for me, if you feel you gotta go outside of us to get something, you can stay there. You can stay there because I don't know. It's just, for me, I know that I wouldn't cheat on somebody because I wouldn't want that done to me. So that's just how I feel about it. And it's not even once, it's twice. Then you lied about it. Then she lied about it once. And then she lied about it happening. How do I know it didn't happen six times? You know, it's like, okay, I'll give you another chance. You know, did you know, what kind of sex did you have with this person? And, it's too much. For me, it's too much. You went, did you do? You wanted to know if you missed it. Hope you liked it. Can I be in your kid's life? That's all I got to say. Anyway, I want to know what you have to say about all I've just said. Chime in down below. Thank y'all for watching. Remember, y'all can submit your questions through my email, my Tumblr, even down below in this video. Thank y'all for watching, and I'm out this shit. Did I say I'm out this shit? Thank y'all for watching. I'm out this bitch.